Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Coulter Field. Today's game has our Gaiters hosting University of Quebec at Montreal. Kickoff is set for 4 p.m. as we have the pregame handshake. My name is Doug Jarvis, and beside me I have
Carm Burke.
So we'd just like to welcome you. So this game's in high anticipation. The Lady Gaiters playing their homecoming game. Pretty big deal, and looking to get a big W out of it.
Yeah, I hope it's a good quality match out there today. Hopefully the ladies play nice and hard.
Yeah, they've got a couple draws under the belt already, so you know they can only go up, and they're getting promising results, and they're improving every game. So hopefully we can see a great game from all the ladies on the field. And turn out that big W. So the captains of each team, captain of the Gaiters would be Allison Verville, and the captain of the UQAM team would be number 21, Sarah Bernard Lakai.
What would you say is the Bishop's Gaiters captain's best quality out there?
Defensively, very strong. She's short, but knows how to get the ball to her feet real quick, and plays with her mind, not with her strength. So, you know, she's a smart player to play against, and definitely makes it hard to for offensive players.
Yeah, she's going to definitely have to get the Gaiters working as a team out there.
Absolutely.
They're going to get a W tonight.
Absolutely. These girls are going to have to work real hard. It's a game about 90 minutes. It's not about 20 minutes here and there, not about 10 minutes here and there. It's about full 90 minutes of pushing hard. So there we go. UQAM taking early control, but...
good pressure there by the Bishops.
Gators. Yeah, great way to play the ball hard. Number 10 on the run, and that would be number 10, Lisa Marie Pelletier. There we see number 21 for Bishops is Aquila, playing hard in the paint. That's good.
Seems like both teams are lining up here with a 4-4-2 formation. So
definitely the preferred formation for most teams at this level, but sometimes you see some interesting ones. We may see a change later on. Both teams are known to get creative, and in the need of a goal, they can make changes. It's a big shot by the team captain off the yellow upright. That's out of play.
Definitely the Bishop's Gaiters will have to be wary of UCAM's height out there. Looks like they're going to be trying to swing in a lot of crosses, so Molly Buchholz will definitely have to be aware of any aerial threats in the box.
No, that was off the bar there. And so there we have it. Going down the right wing with Steph Burnett on the ball, passing up to Aquila. Seeing Krista Wilson there. Number 8 with the ball off to the center of the field. Nice switch down the field. Back to the defense, playing back on that D-line. That would be Kelly McInnery. And as Fred tracks back into the box. Ball's out of play on the back touchline. We'll see Molly Buchholz take that goal kick.
It's great to see her back in play. Last year she had knee surgery, so it's good to see her back out there on the field.
Yeah, and you might notice that the defense can take a lot of the kicks. That's just because Molly's knee isn't always 100%, and so she's got to keep ready for everything. But yeah, that ball was an offside ball. It's my bad. It wasn't a back touch. It was an offside. Here's Christa with a throw-in.
Definitely think the key to this game is if the Bishop's Gaiters can try to use the width of the pitch out there. spread the play out and keep possession of the ball, they should have a good chance of keeping the score line close.
Mm-hmm. And today the ladies will be using the yellow touchline, not the white touchline, if you are wondering. Nice fight down the side there between Kelly and her opposition. There's Patricia Murray taking a touch on the ball. Patricia Murray looking for it. Can't find the outlet and gets rid of it in a safe manner. And here we go. We have a bit of an opportunity. There's Steph passing up for Jackie Lothar.
Good pressure on the ball there. Bishop's moving. Nice counterattack.
I at least believe that's Jackie. I'll have to check on that one. Great way to put some pressure on the ball. Yeah. Gaiters put the ball into the box. There's UQAM taking control in the middle of the field. Patricia Murray getting in the way of that one. So on the back line, I think the Gaiters defense on the far left wing, starting I don't know if he's on the left wing anymore. We have Fred on the right wing, Kelly in the middle, Allison in the middle, and then Christina Georgiopoulos probably on the left wing, it seems.
Good through ball up there.
Yeah, in the middle you have Shelby Raven playing right wing or right mid, it seems, right center mid, and then Krista Wilson playing dead center mid with Patricia Murray, and on the left wing either Jackie or... Jackie, and then Akilah and Steph up front. That makes sense. Yeah. Here's Patricia Murray fighting, getting down the paint, getting dirty. Got to dig deep with these girls. You can't just play soft. Awesome verbal with the stop.
Poor pass there by UQAM. They should hold up the ball more.
Yeah, I think BU's holding off them, let them make their own mistakes. And that might just be the way to play this team at this point in the game, with energy levels equal. And Jackie Lothar having a tough time getting that outlet pass, leaving for Shelby Raven, and a long ball there for Akilah.
Jackie's definitely doing a good job up there. If the midfielders or defenders can get the outlet ball to her, she's doing a good job of holding up play. So I think she's a key outlet there for Bishops tonight.
Oh, absolutely. She's definitely a key player. A bit of a rough play in the back line there on Kelly. Kelly McKinnery has also come back from knee surgery. This team was riddled with injuries by the end of last year, but they've recovered well. This is awesome riddle with a kick. If you're wondering, the yellow armband on Allison's leg, as well as Molly Buchholz, the keeper's leg, that is their captain bands, showcasing their captaincy. That's Allison Riverville on number 6 of UQAM, who is Evelyn Cote.
Good defensive play there, safety first.
Yeah, absolutely. Nothing wrong with putting the ball out when necessary.
Just keep things simple out there, and a Bishop should be fine. We should have a good game of soccer for both teams.
Number 21 with the corner is Sarah Bernard-Lakai, and that's the captain.
One thing Bishops do have to be aware of is the UQAM team is a much taller than them, so they're definitely posing a good threat on corner kicks.
And that swinging ball is definitely dangerous. Pushed out to number 11, Maude Fortin. Out in the wing there to number 3.
Another great ball in there by UQAM.
Yeah, by number 3, Pamela Galeb-Poitras. And Molly sets up that goal kick. Luckily, another chance going wide. And we have a substitution. Looks like number 21, Akilah, is cramping up. And coming on for Akilah would be... Number 10, Brett McCaver. Brett's a rookie up front. So is Jackie, and Steph's the vet up there. Other rookies on the field notables would be on the back line, Christina Georgiopoulos. Otherwise, we're sitting on a team of second and third year vets with a couple fourth years. Allison Verville tripping over the ball. Patricia Murray taking that cover back and getting rid of it, moving the ball, and a bit of a sloppy play, but with some recovery by Christina Georgiopoulos.
Good play there by Bishop, just moving the ball out of pressure.
Absolutely. Now, Karam, what would you say is Bishop's greatest feature so far in this game? What do you got to work on?
I think they should still keep focusing on the counterattack and getting the ball up front to...
Akilah's no longer up there, but Brett and Jackie and Steph. I agree, as a team that's getting a lot of pressure put on them, if they can keep that out of danger on those plays, a ball like this out to Fred is perfect ball. Oh, come on. Freddie with that cross is an absolute beautiful play. Way to put some pressure on their BU girls, and Kelly McHenry taking it by herself in the back, putting it through. Oh, nice idea on the three ball.
Good pressure here by Bishop.
Shelby putting it wide. Oh. Yeah, good run by Steph Burnett.
It's a good set of pressure there by Lady Gators. So.
Yeah, you really can't complain about those kind of plays, and I think as the game goes on, we'll see more and more of them.
Definitely got to try to keep the ball on the other end, and should be good.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you can't complain if the ball's on the other end of the, at the end of the half. And what about UQAM? What are your thoughts on UQAM?
I think UQAM definitely should keep trying to get more crosses into the box and using their aerial advantage, because they're coming very close with headers and they have great height difference on their team compared to Bishop. So I think that's the greatest chance they have of winning this game. Keep getting balls into that box.
I mean, the ball's in the box, number one. Number two is using their height to their advantage. And Bishop's really doesn't have that height, but... if Bishop wants to win this game, they have to play smart when UCAM's on the ball. I was speaking with a number of the Lady Gators earlier this season, and the outlook on the season, they went essentially 5-0, technically 4-1 in the preseason, and had a great outlook. I think they just sort of had some stumbling around and not being able to settle into their formations and really work to their strengths. But they got to keep their spirits up and keep working hard, pushing. And, you know, you don't win a championship overnight. You don't build a championship team overnight. Everyone's got to be patient.
Definitely. Like you said, the soccer is a 90-minute game, so take each game as it comes and try to grind out a result.
Yeah, and that's about it, too. You don't win a game in 1 minute either. You win a game over 90 minutes. So, yeah, you really can't – the girls can't get discouraged off a few losses early in the season. And a big win tonight would be absolutely monumental going forward.
Yeah, just keep focusing on being a hard team to play against, and hopefully they can grind out a few results.
Yeah, absolutely. I completely agree. They brought in a number of first-year girls who are quite talented, and hopefully with those acquisitions they can make some big moves. But completely understandable that they can get frustrated off a few losses.
I think the key player for UCAM that Bishops has to watch out for is Lisa Marie Peltier.
Very, very nice through ball. Krista Wilson, with a header to the back. Shelby Raven taking the ball down to Krista. Krista going wide to Steph. Steph going to put it in the box. Mistakes the cross. Looks like she may have dinged her finger a little bit, but getting up decently. And Bishops really just needs to regroup and try it again, because those kind of plays are what will get them the win.
I think if UQAM focus on getting the ball to their number 10, they should be very good. She's a very good player on the ball, and she's very creative there in the middle of the park. Bishop should watch out for her there.
If Steph could have just taken that ball down, it's that close. This game isn't it's not quite the precision game that you're used to watching, so these girls can take chances and take advantage of the opportunities they get. So putting that out of play was UQAM, and Steph Burnett's going to put it back in a throw-in to Shelby Raven. Shelby back to Steph. Steph into the cross. Into the keeper's gloves there. Playing up to number 14, Andre Garipe.
Definitely no one has a foothold on this game yet, so it could go either way.
And you know, soccer's a game of... game of minutes where you can't, every minute's different. You can't just say that the game's lost there, game's won there. So even if the girls go down a goal, there's no stopping them from scoring a couple. Allison Verville taking charge here, putting her body into that one. I believe that's a call on the ground for a foul. Number three will be taking this for UQAM, Pamela Gillette-Poitras. The cross in. Gator's got to get on that. Well played by Shelby. Well played. And back to number three.
Another ball there in the box.
I believe that was a push in the middle of the box called by the referee.
Bishop's Gators have to watch themselves giving away free kicks because they are definitely at a disadvantage for headers in the box there, so they're going to want to limit the amount of free kicks they give in their end of the field.
Absolutely, you're absolutely right. And as you can see, Allison Verville found that ball not to her standard. Exchange it for a new one. Placing that ball, as the ref says. So Allison and Molly played club soccer together back in the day. Good friends all the way through high school playing together, and came to Bishop's together to continue to play together. So there's a lot of chemistry in the back in there. And with the new rookies, they should have some great chemistry in the next year, specifically as Molly and Allison's year moves into the last year next year. That's the UQAM keeper kicking out to number 21, the captain, Sarah Bernard Lakai. That's Allison Verville.
Nice tackle by Ali Verville.
Yeah, getting a tackle and getting into the play. That's Molly coming out in the ball, well up, taking charge in the box. That's exactly what you need to see from a keeper in this stage of the game. No big shot, no big chances yet. Really have to establish yourself as the boss of the box, and that's it. No question about it. That's number 12, Christina Georgiopoulos, booting it up the sideline and out of play. Take the throws, number 14, Angie Garipe.
Nice tackle there by Brett McCaver.
Yes, Brett, the recent sub. We'll see how Akila's doing, see if that injury takes her out for the entire game as a starting striker, but hopefully it's just maybe just a cramp or a Charlie horse, something that can be walked off. We'd love to see her back, as we like to see all the Gators getting some good playing time. The girls started this year off with a training camp down in San Francisco, where they got to really bond and become a team together. They fundraised money through selling tickets for a raffle to win a trip to Hawaii. I bought some tickets. I didn't win a trip to Hawaii, though. But the girls had a great time down there, and that was the most important thing.
Trip to Hawaii sounds nice.
Yeah. Well, as UQAM gives away a free kick. We'll see how Allison Verbal's scoring ability comes into play at 25 yards out. I know she was practicing these over the summer, and she might have a decent chance, but with a wall involved, it's all different. And practice and game time is a lot. There's a big difference between the two. Looker to put it aim top corner somewhere. She's notorious for putting it off the bar, and can really locate the spot with the ball. Now, as you see, the refs move the wall back, and here comes the kick. The nice kick on goal. That's a save by the keeper. Way to get the ball in by Allison Verville, but unfortunately we couldn't get much traffic in there. We have a decent crowd out here today for all of you at home. About 80, 90-odd people coming out to support the Lady Gaiters and show some love to their fellow athletes. As UQAM gives away another free kick.
Just the beginning of Bishop's homecoming weekend, so expect the crowds to get much larger throughout the day
And throughout the weekend.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow's game should be absolutely packed full of people as we have a great football team playing tomorrow. And here comes Allison up for another free kick. Nice cross in the box. Unfortunately, no head on it.
Great ball in the box there. Just not enough movement there by the Lady Gaiters up front.
That's
trying to get a head on that.
That's unfortunate that they couldn't get a head on it. But like you're saying, that strength and size is definitely a problem. But the Lady Gaiters can definitely make a win out of it regardless. Nice pressure by the Gaiters. A nice ball in the box by Steph and saved by the keeper. That's save number three for the keeper, getting some traffic in, and only Molly Buchholz has only saved one so far. Not a lot of traffic going the other way.
UCAM's goalie Valerie Lobb, very good with her hands, not giving any rebounds at all. So
And don't question the strength of these girls' shots. I've seen them; some of them are absolute cannons. So, you can only imagine the strength it takes to hold a ball as a shot comes in.
Nice recovery play there by Fred Cloutier.
Yes. Fred Cloutier is one of the vets out there. She's been playing on the team for a while. Scored last year on this game, scored the only goal for the team, and scored a goal earlier this season. So Fred's definitely a formidable opponent for everyone, and playing wing defense isn't her natural position, but she's fit in well this year. As the Gaiters give up a free kick, some of the most dangerous plays start off things like this, and Gaiters have already given up a couple goals this season free kick rather.
Players to watch there for UQAM in the box are number 23 and number 10, two offensive players who are quite tall,
close to six feet tall
out there.
Beautiful header by Shelby Raven, absolute selfless ball. Also very well on the clear, scuffed a little bit, and Fred's really pushing in on that. That's great way to play with these ladies. Nothing wrong with playing with heart.
Poor pass there.
Yeah, poor pass by Brett. I don't think Brett's that's not her strong suit. She's striking for a reason, to take those shots and put them in the back of the net. But I mean, effort's worth 10 times more than any other skill is, and I think that's the most important. So as long as these girls keep their effort up and keep pushing hard. So here comes another free kick. Look for a cross through into the box. Same danger play. Whoever gets a head on it is going to get a try on that. And that would be Krista Wilson going out, putting it out for a corner, which is not a bad play. Not the most ideal, but nothing wrong as long as you get a head on it. And number three, Pamela, will be taking that kick for University of Quebec in Montreal.
Definitely a great dead ball striker there, Pamela, for UQAM. She's hitting those crosses and very nice. Great flat level. As long as one of those UQAM players get their heads on it, should be definitely a goal threat.
And here comes the cross in. As Shelby or Krista falls, the shot goes wide, which is an absolute lucky play. I think all those girls should be thankful for that one. That's not a ball you want to see hanging out in the box for long. As we come up on 25 minutes, the score is 0-0 still. Saves are 3-1 apiece. 3-1, three shots on net by Bishops, which is a great start. We'll see this team progress as the game goes. The wind, as you can see by the flags at the end of the field, is coming off from the Farmers Field towards the St. Francis River, and that may play a factor in strikes and goal kicks for both teams. Temperature at field level is about 8 degrees. On a brisk September evening.
Definitely with my experience, I'd say this is probably the best weather to play a nice game of soccer in. Not too hot or not too cold, so.
Yeah, absolutely.
The
and
girls are probably enjoying it out there.
Absolutely. It definitely beats the snow-covered pitch that Bishops often plays in as we get winter early and long here. As the ball gets played back in, Krista Wilson touches back to Trisha Murray. Trisha Murray on the fake, trying to dribble around. Can't make the move. Austin Riverville back in. Shelby Raven with another touch. Puts it wide to Steph Burnett. Steph Burnett giving a try on it. And no dice. Ref on that play played advantage. And since there wasn't much of a play that came out of it, we'll put the ball back to the spot where Shelby was taken down.
See what Allie Burville can do here 30 yards out.
30 yards out, her proficiency definitely drops. We'll see if she can get it on net, but she might be looking to make a cross to the wing or maybe putting it into a through ball or something like that. It looks, though, as if Krista Wilson's setting up to take it, so yeah, I believe Krista Wilson will be taking it. Krista Wilson is one person to have an absolute cannon of a shot, known league-wide. And there's the blast. Not a bad shot at all to...
Definitely had the pace, just not the accuracy there.
And you know what? Some days you just can't buy the accuracy, and some days you can't buy the pace. So she got one or the other. And we'll see if she can put it to better use as the game continues. And if you aren't already following us on Twitter, our Twitter account is Bishops Gaiters. You can... if you can't listen in, you can always see live score updates on Twitter there and keep in tune with what's going on in the Gator world.
Great fight for the ball there between the two teams.
Absolutely. That's exactly what you want to see between these girls. Fight hard. Bishops knows it's their homecoming, and UQAM knows they're going to come out hard because it's homecoming. So high-quality matches. Exactly what we're going to see. As the Gators give away another free kick.
Short ball played there. Nice tackle.
Nice defensive play by Patricia Murray. Pass off to Christina Georgopoulos, who's running upfield with a nice three ball to Steph Burnett. Steph takes it down. Goes one on two. Can't make it happen. Freddie on the follow-up. Beautiful ball to Jackie Lothar. Jackie sidesteps with the ball back again. As a miscommunication happens down deep between Steph and Jackie. Unfortunately, those are the kind of things that break down as these girls continue to work on their chemistry, but it's also something that will come to them quite quickly once once they start putting some W's together and stringing together passes.
Just looking out there at the stands, people are slowly filling up the seats.
After this, we have women's rugby match, and then we have men's rugby. So it's a night of festivities for Bishops, and all games should be absolute quality. That's Brett in the middle there, making the incomplete pass to Steph. Steph putting pressure on. So yeah, number four, Steph. Number three, Jackie Lothar. Number 10 is Brett. Number 19 is Crystal Wilson. Number 12, that'd be Christina Georgiopoulos. That's Patricia Murray with the ball right now. Putting it back right into number three, UQAM, who is Pamela. Ball right back in, played out by Kelly McInerney, which is a great ball out. And as UQAM gives up a free kick to the slippery Patricia Murray. So the keeper for UQAM there, Valerie Labie, playing quite well in the back, making some touches on the ball as the ball goes back to their defensive line. Steph Burnett putting it up to Jackie. Jackie seeing the support. Steph putting it back in. Patricia Murray running onto that ball, taking a touch and making a play somewhere, hopefully, but falling down before that. Krista Wilson on the wing. Taken out.
Definitely need to see a little bit more movement out there by the ladies. Not giving their players too many options when they're on the ball.
I think the Gaiters are going through cycles of aggression and lesser aggression. The high aggression is when they're playing their best, and then they drop back and lose some energy. But, you know, like right now, the play's slow, and they aren't really keeping pace, but once the play picks up, they're right back into it. So look for a couple quick passes just to get this game moving again, and hopefully you can see a big goal out of it.
Definitely. Just try to keep the ball moving, short, quick passes, and stay away from the long ball. I find they're going to be a lot more successful out there if they try to keep it 10, 20-yard passes on the ground.
Yeah, 10-yard passes are ideal. The long ball, especially without the height, is definitely not their best option. As you see from that ball in, there just isn't the presence up on the height. So it's a tough game to play in the air.
Well, with 31 minutes gone, definitely the coach will be aware of that. And then halftime talk, maybe switch up their tactic a bit there for the Bishops Gaiters.
Yeah, we can definitely look out for that as the second half goes on too.
Great positives, though, on their pressing down on the ball. They're definitely winning it back in the UCAM's half, which is very, very good for the Gaiters out there. Great positive take from the first half.
Yep, absolutely. That's a nice sliding tackle by UCAM on Crystal Wilson. Nice to see a good fair sliding tackle here on the end of the game. Christina Georgiopoulos with the clear. Brett back to a nice pass back to Krista Wilson, where she dishes it down the line to nobody, unfortunately. And back to the keeper, Valerie. As Valerie passes the right wing putting it up the line, back into the middle, and back to the keeper. Start all over again, which isn't a bad thing. Keeping UQAM on their toes. Jackie Lothar giving it a run. Why not, right? This is the kind of game that you can win on a goal like that.
Nice movement out there, pushing the ball wide by Fred.
That's Steph Burnett on getting the free kick, getting awarded the free kick, which is great. on a push, I believe.
Great opportunity here. Hopefully Ali Vrabel can get a nice cross in and Bishops can get a strike on that.
Absolutely. I know Allison's also been working on this kind of cross, but she swings it in going almost towards the near post and then cutting it back towards the sideline. And that's definitely their best chance when you put someone close to that back post. Draws the goalie out and really opens up the field.
Not a lot of movement in the box right now, but...
That's the ball. It goes in, and unfortunately, Allison doesn't get a good hand on or a good foot on it, but the keeper didn't get a good hand on it either, so... Nice play by Brett to put pressure on Jackie coming in to help. Oh, unfortunately, that play was deemed a little bit too rough by the referee. The CIS refs are clearly on their game day vision, seeing everything.
Definitely what this game needs is a goal just to open things up a bit. Right now, both teams are just canceling each other out in the middle of the park.
Yeah, and it's not a bad thing for Bishops. Bishops, you don't want to be fighting from behind. Not in this kind of soccer. That's Kelly booting it up. Krista clearing out to the middle to no one, but Jackie trying to fix the problem, and there it is. Some good wrestling in the middle on the ball, which is exactly what you want to see from a team like Bishops.
Great play by Jackie up front. I think she's been the key player for Bishops tonight.
Yeah, I think so far she's probably had the best chances. Maybe not in the sense of scoring, but definitely putting the ball in the right spot. That's a great head out by Allison Verville before they put it back in the box. And Molly Buchholz puts on the second save of her game. Nothing wrong with catching that ball right in the breadbasket.
Nice hold up.
Nice cross over there. Well communicated. Now to Krista on the wing. Krista, unfortunately, couldn't make much of it and let it go out of play. Krista line up to take it again. She has some great support there. I'll see how far this throw goes. And she hit Jackie in the middle. Jackie trying to make a run out of it. Back to Krista. Krista back to Patricia. Brett back to Christina. And out of play off the UCAM player.
Definitely, since Brett has come on for the Gaiters, she's formed a formidable partnership up front there with...
That's that ball from Allison. Goes just over her head. With Steph there or Jackie?
Jackie.
Yeah, absolutely. Jackie's been absolutely brilliant up front. And as you can see, the run by Allison Verville going in the middle. Their center defender trying to make some offense happen as Steph Burnett boots it off the UCAM player. Yeah. Freddie will be taking this throw in, number 20. Nice pass to Patricia Murray, who can't do much with it, but gets it back. Back to Kelly McHenry, to Krista Wilson, to Allison Verville, right down the middle. And the BU Gaiters just won't let that ball get unrecycled. Just recycling, recycling, recycling. That's exactly what they need to be doing as the team in the lesser half there. Yeah, both teams regroup and walk back on this free kick. So you say in your history there, Karim, what do you do in a game like this where you really can't get a break and it's a dead heat, if you will?
I think for the Bishops Gaiters and UCAM, they should just focus on keeping the ball in the other opposition's half and just keep possession. Just don't force anything. Almost just probe in the other team's end. So move the ball from midfield through the back line and just wait for an opening and try to slip it through ball through up front or
Absolutely.
Don't rush a chance. Wait for the chance to almost come to you, because if they keep the ball moving, they're going to tire the other team out, especially in a game like this where both teams are very good defensively.
I completely agree. The play in the back end is definitely number one and primary, and the D-line has some great ball movement, so nothing wrong with playing with the ball in the back and force it forward only when there's a chance. There's no point in pressing when you don't have anything, and you don't want to risk having a counter strike on you that ends up in the back of the net. That's Patricia Murray there. Oh, yeah, Patricia Murray with the interception. Yes. And Shelby couldn't do much with that ball and sent it into a pile of players. That's Jackie running around trying to keep it calm and recycle that ball, putting in some great effort.
Definitely a great defensive effort by the Bishop's front line there. They're the first line of defense, and they're closing down the other team's back line when they have the ball, not letting them move it out of their end.
Yeah, I completely agree. And that's number 13 there, Sabrina Adana, who just went magically around every BU player on the field. But as Bishop's doing before, UQAM is starting to try and recycle that ball unfruitfully, as it seems, as they've just given it away.
Great physical play up front there by Jackie and Brett.
I think you can't win a game like this without being physical. There's no point in coming to a game if you're not ready to be physical and put your elbow in and try what you got to do, especially in that part of the field. Nothing wrong with taking or giving away a free kick. Nothing wrong with that at all. That's part of the game, and you can't just play soft. You can't just let the other team take control.
Exactly. That back line for UQAM is always going to be wary of when they receive possession of the ball, looking out for either Brett or Jackie.
Yeah, absolutely.
So they know they're going to be right on their back heels.
I completely agree, and I think that's probably the strong suit of the game so far. That's what they can take away, is that they put great pressure up front, and that's what they want to be doing.
You can definitely tell the preseason for the Bishop's Gaiters has helped them. They've been able to close down the team and keep a lot of pressure and their legs moving, and they don't look tired yet, which is probably...
That's a great thing. You know, in previous years, this far into a game, you'd see girls not being able to communicate, not being able to pass and stuff like that. As you can see, Molly Buchholz, the keeper there, is calling her own defenseman off the ball, which is absolutely perfect of this caliber. Patricia Murray taking the ball on, passing it wide to Christina Georgiopoulos, who then dishes the ball to Brett, who can't really force much out of it, but stays on it. That's Crystal Wilson putting pressure in back to Patricia Murray, and Murray making some dancing moves, but one too many, and that's sort of what happens. But the ball is getting recycled. Here's Freddie on the ball up the right wing to Shelby. Shelby can't make a good touch on the ball, unfortunately, and it's out to number 21. Of UQAM, Sarah Bernard. The pass to Allison Riverwell at the feet. Allison makes a pass. It's a missed header by UQAM, but they regain control. The back line, number 8. That was a gimme of a pass. Unfortunately, Brett could not capitalize. So I'll be doing numbers out there. We got
42 minutes gone.
How many people on the bench, do you think, or rather in the stadium?
There's probably close to 70, 80 people out there.
Yeah,
now, so.
I'd say so. You know, it's only to grow as the game goes on. Last year, these girls played at 6 p.m. and got the benefit of two crowds, the women's rugby crowd, who played before them, and their own crowd. And that was quite a lively game. We had the pleasure of having Dean Bailey arrive, as well as a couple other big administration members, to watch the game as the Lady Gaiters took on, I believe, UQAM and won 1-0. also taking the free kick quite quickly to try and keep UQAM on their toes. And a volley by Trish Murray goes wide.
Nothing wrong with that. Just keep shooting, and eventually you'll hit that net, and you have a chance of maybe one going in.
Yeah.
You never know.
And like I said, these girls, they aren't bad. That's for sure. They all are good at their own thing, and Trisha is known as a great goal scorer when she gets her chances. So she knows she can do it. She's got the confidence, and that's the best thing about it. A beautiful play by Steph Burnett. That's exactly what you want to see out of your right winger. And the ref backs up number 21. Sarah Bernard.
Unlucky there by Patricia Murray there, defending the ball. Just unlucky bounce off her shins for the UQAM throw.
Yeah, and well, soccer's too much like that. You can't really count on every bounce. You can't count on every ball. So... And if you want to tune in live for the second half...